Welcome students, in today's session we will be studying about very important and precious substance on the planet earth, that is water. So let's start chapter 5, water. What is water? Water is one of the most important substance as well as precious substance on the earth. All plants and animals must have water to survive. For survival, water is very very important. If there was no water, there would be no life on the earth. Means without water, we cannot imagine life on the earth. Water that is safe for drinking is called potable water. Potable water, safe water, clean water keeps us safe from the various hazardous diseases. There are various sources from where we can collect water. So step by step we will study about what is water, sources of water and the other forms of the waters. What we will learn from this chapter, which things we are going to study. Water is important for our life. Why? Water, what is water cycle and what are the sources of water? Also, we will learn about water springs in the oceans. So let's start the lesson. Water cycle. The process by which water continuously changes its form and circulates between oceans, atmosphere and land is known as the water cycle. With the help of this diagram, we will see. Here you can see collected groundwater. This groundwater, due to sun's heat, get evaporated. Then this water converting into steam. Then this steam or the evaporated water get condensed. Means condensation process takes place. After condensation process, precipitation takes place. And after the precipitation, water get converted into water droplets as well as in the snow, in the form of snow. Then this rain and snow get down, and with the help of the surface runoff, this rain and snow or the ice particles get collected over there again in the form of groundwater. So this process is called as water cycle. Now, sources of water. From which sources we get water? The major sources of fresh water are the rivers, ponds, springs and the glaciers. The ocean bodies and the seas contain salty water. So, major sources of fresh water and salty water, they are totally different. Fresh water sources, rivers, ponds, springs and the glaciers. Glaciers means ice of rivers. And the ocean bodies like oceans and the seas water, which is much salty, which contains salty water. So we cannot directly use that water. But the salty water is also helpful for the activate water cycle as well as for the transportation, as well as much treasure is hidden in the sea. So we are having lot of importance in the point of view of these oceans and sea water. Most of the salt is sodium chloride, which is we obtain from the sea water or the common table salt that we eat. So salt, which is sodium chloride, which we use to eat. Now, distribution of water bodies. How the distribution of water bodies on the planet Earth, we can see 3/4 of the Earth's surface is covered by the water. But then too, most probably we have seen that various campaigns rising cause of to save water, save life. Why? Even though lot of proportion, 3/4 portion of the earth surface which is covered by the water, but my dear students, even though 3/4 of the earth surface water which is cover part of the earth surface which is covered by the water, but whole water or entire water body we cannot use to consume or use for our daily purpose. Water is absolutely essential for survival. Water alone can quench our thirst when we are thirsty. Means when we are thirsty, only water can fit for consumption. Only water can fulfill our need, our thirst. For that reason, water is very, very precious substance on the planet Earth. We will see how it get distributed on the Earth surface. You can see in the first column, among the 100%, 97% water, which is saline water, which is accumulated in the form of ocean and seas. Among that, only 3% water, that is fresh water, that is fit for human consumption, fit for human use. Means 97% water, that this water is salty water. Now, among this 3% water, you can see here, from that 3% fresh water, 68.7% water, which is in ice caps as well as is in the form of glaciers. Then 30.1% water is available in the underground, means groundwater storage 30.1%, and other 0.9% water which is here you can see surface water 0.3%. Among that surface water, 87% water which is accumulated in lakes, various lakes, swamps, and in the form of river 2% water. So from this entire chart, what we can consider, only 3% water, fresh water storage available on the planet Earth. Among this 3% water, much water is in the form of ice caps and the glaciers, groundwater, ice caps and glaciers, then lakes, rivers, swamps, etc. So that's why there is a need to raise voice again and again about the save water, save life. Now, ocean circulation. Ocean water, it never stays still. Water always keeps on flowing. This ocean water, sometimes, in the form of waves, in the form of destructive tides, in the form of currents, it always keeps on flowing. The flowing water in oceans is categorized into three parts. See, the flowing water in oceans is categorized due to its flow, it categorized into three parts: waves, tides, and currents. See, students, waves, tides, and currents, these are the movements of the ocean water, but due to its flow, these movements of water categorized into various ways, that is waves, tides, and currents. The movements that occur in ocean can be broadly categorized as waves, tides, and currents. See, waves. What are waves? When the water on the surface of the ocean rises and falls alternately, they are called waves. As you look towards the oceans and seas, what you can observe, ocean water rises and falls alternately. So that is called as sea waves. During a storm, the winds blowing at very high speed form huge waves. Sometimes, due to the storm, what is happening? These waves at very high speed. They are reaching towards the sea coast. These may cause tremendous destruction. An earthquake, a volcanic eruption, or underground landslides can shift large amount of ocean water. And due to that, what happened? Due to inside an earthquake or underwater landslide, what is happening? This ocean water rising and falling at very high speed, and cause of that destruction takes place near the sea coast in the form of life, as well as due to the property destructions, life destruction takes place. We can take an example like tsunami, etc. As a result, a huge tidal wave called tsunami is formed, and we know very well that how destruction takes place due to this high speed waves. Now, tides. The rhythmic rise and fall of ocean water twice in a day is called a tide. See, my dear students, difference between waves and tides, that is, waves continuously occur on the surface of ocean, but tides is the rhythmic rise and fall of ocean water twice in a day is called a tide. It is high tide when water covers much of the shore, means sea coast side, much of the sea coast which covered by the waves, that is called high tide, by rising to its highest level. And it is low tide when water falls to its lowest level and recedes from the shore. So high tide and low tide, these type of the rhythmic rise and fall of ocean water twice in a day is called a tide. Now, there are two types of tides, spring tides and neap tides. Among that, we will see spring tides. The strong gravitational pull exerted by the sun and the moon on the earth's surface causes the tides. Due to the sun's gravitational force and the moon's gravitational force, earth's surface water gets pulled. And cause of that, high and low tides occur on the earth's surface. During the full moon and new moon day, full moon Purnima and new moon day Amavasya, the sun and the moon and the earth are in the same line. You can see the sun, moon and the earth, they are in the same line, and cause of that, what is happening? Cause of sun, moon and the earth in the same line, and cause of that, what is happening? Tides are at the highest, and these tides are called as spring tides. So spring tides means when the sun, moon and the earth lie in the same line, and such tides occur, those tides are called as spring tides. Now, the neap tides. When the moon is in its first and last quarter, the ocean waters get drawn in diagonally opposite direction by the gravitational pull of sun and moon, resulting in low tides. Suppose, my dear students, this is sun, this is earth, and here is suppose moon. So they are in the right angle degree, and in this position, such type of, actually here you can see, whatever the water on the surface of the earth, due to sun's gravitational pull, it get pulled towards the sun, as well as here due to moon's gravitational pull, water get pulled towards the cause of the gravitational pull. So hence, what is happening due to the gravitational pull of sun and the moon, high and low tides occur towards on the surface of the earth. So these tides are called as neap tides. Here you can see spring tide You can see here sun, moon and earth. They are in the straight line. So that time what is happening? Due to the moon gravitational force and due to the sun's gravitational force, these earth, water, surface water gets pulled, and that's why high tides occur over there. You can see here sun, moon and the earth, they are in this angle. So that time what is happening? Due to the moon gravitational force, strong moon gravitational force, what is happening? Here high tides occur and here low tides occur. So these are called as neap tides. So spring tides and neap tides, these are two types of tides, occur twice. Ocean currents. Ocean currents are streams of water flowing constantly on the ocean surface in definite directions. The ocean currents may be warm or cold. Remember, my dear students, these ocean currents, these are warm and cold. Two types of ocean currents are there, warm currents and cold currents. The warm ocean currents originates near the equator. See, warm, hot ocean currents. These originates where? Equator. Why warm ocean currents originate equator? Because of on the equator, sunlight fall straight. Straight sunlight fall on the equator, and that's why what is happening? Their water get heated earlier than the pole and move towards the poles. The cold currents carry water from the polar or higher latitudes to the tropical or lower latitudes. Tropical or lower latitudes means towards the equator, towards the Tropic of Cancer or Tropic of Capricorn. Warm currents bring about warm temperature over land surface. Means suppose those regions are located near the equatorial zone, there warm currents, and due to that warm current, warm temperature also create over there. The areas where the warm and cold currents meet provide the best fishing grounds of the world. The seas around Japan and the eastern coast of North America are such examples. The areas where warm and cold currents meet experience foggy weather. Foggy weather, which is like fog-like situation, means where warm and cold currents meet and create over there fog, and cause of that foggy we cannot for the vision it is very difficult to see if we will go towards the mountainous areas, and due to the foggy weather very difficult to drive. Like that, very difficult when foggy weather during for the navigation. Now you can see here equator. This is called as tropical area, and where especially warm currents generate because of why? Because of sunlight falls straight on this equatorial region. So that's why here warm currents create, and towards the polar area what is sunlight falls slanting, and cause of that here cold currents we can find, here cold currents towards the polar regions. Now here see cold ocean currents, these flow from north pole to equator, north pole to equator. These are the cold currents, and cold currents flow north pole to equator, and warm ocean currents, these flow from equator to north pole. Listen, my dear student, this is the equator, and from the equator these warm currents flow towards the north pole, and cold currents north pole to south pole. Like that way warm currents equator to south pole, and cold currents south pole to equator. In this manner, warm currents and the cold currents flow. You can see on the global map you can see this is the red reddish. You can see the lines which indicates warm currents which especially get generated on the equatorial area, and due to the flow of this warm current, the entire area also get warm temperature or the climate. And you can see here blue lines which indicates cold currents. These cold currents move towards the equatorial region, warm currents move towards the polar region, towards the south pole, towards the north pole. I hope you understood this chapter.